There's a story about a horse. Kind of another story where you can't judge a guy, you know, that first impressions.
Like me.
We was camped out on the plains at the head of the Cimarron. Along come a stranger and he stopped to argue some. He looked so very foolish and began to look around, and we thought he was a greenhorn and he'd just escaped from town. We'd asked if he'd had breakfast and he hadn't had a sniff. We opened up the chuck box and told him help yourself. He took a little beefsteak, a biscuit and some beans, and he then begun to talk about the foreign kings and queens. He talked about the Spanish war and fighting on the sea, with guns as big as beef steers and ramrods big as trees. He talked about old Paul Jones, a fighting son of a gun, and he said he was the grittiest cuss that ever pulled a gun. Now he said he lost his job out upon the Santa Fe, and he was going across the plains to strike the 70. Well, he didn't say how come, it just some trouble with his boss. He said he'd like to borrow a nice fat saddle horse. This tickled all the boys to death. We laughed and in their sleeves. We said that he could have a horse as fresh as he would please. So Shorty grabbed the lasso when he roped the zebra Dunn and led him to the stranger while we waited for the fun. Now old Dunny was an outlaw. He had grown so awful wild. He could paw the white out of the moon or jump for a mile. He always stood right still, just like he didn't know, until he was saddled and ready for the go. Now the stranger hit the saddle and old Dunny quit the earth. He went straight up in the air for all that he was worth, a bawling and a squalling and having wall-eyed fits, with his hind feet perpendicular and his front ones in the bits. Well, we could see the tops of trees beneath him every jump. The stranger, he was glued there just like a camel's hump. He sat up there upon him and he curled his black mustache, just like a summer boarder just a-waiting for his hash. Now he thumped him in the shoulders and he spurred him when he whirled. He showed us flunky punchers he's the wolf of this old world. And when he had dismounted once again upon the ground, we knew he was a thoroughbred and not a gent from town. Now the boss, he was a-standing and a-watching all the show. He walks right up to him and he asked him not to go. If you can use the lasso like you rode the zebra Dunn, then you're the man I've looked for ever since the year of one. Well, he could use a lasso and he didn't do it slow. The cattle, they stampeded, he was always on the go. A one thing and a sure thing that I learned since I was born, every educated feller, he ain't a plum greenhorn.